joining us this afternoon. My first question is to ma'am, Soni Razdan. How has been your experience been so far with Z5, and would you like to tell us more about the character you're playing?
Sure. I just first would like to say a very, very, very heartfelt thank you to Z5 for showing their keen interest in this movie. And also the fact that I think they're just one of the most amazing platforms that exists today in our fold. The kind of films that they're looking at, I mean, I see their vision is very, 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 you know, far-sighted. And they're definitely looking at a very, very wide audience spectrum. So very, very heartfelt thanks to them. Then, of course, I want to thank my wonderful director for coming to me with this movie. And now, this should not sound like an award speech or something, so we'll move on. Yeah, so the character I'm playing of Michi Kumar is a very unusual character for me to play personally, because she's very, I mean, on the face of it, she's very removed from the kind of life that I lead, the kind of person I am in real life. She's a woman living alone in a crumbling old house in Calcutta, as you saw in the trailer. And she's on the verge of retirement. But I think what I was able to connect to her in Mithi was the feeling of loneliness, because loneliness is an emotion and a feeling that we all feel. Even we can be lonely in a crowd. So, you know, what I connected to in this character was that feeling of aloneness, which I feel very often. I feel it almost every day. Not that I'm leading a lonely life as such, but I just think that the human condition is tough. We are born alone and we die alone, and somewhere in between we are solo travelers, all of us, even though we have, you know, relationships crowding our lives. So I think that feeling and that longing for love and finding somebody whom you haven't perhaps, you know, found in your life yet, it's a very, very universal emotion. So this is what I connected to in Mithi.
All right, thank you so much, ma'am. My next question is to Hannah. We've seen you doing fabulous roles, slaying them all, you know, pulling off diversity in your characters. What was so different that separates you from the rest of the characters you've played so far in the past?
Hi, everybody, and thank you, Aparna, ma'am. This is, first of all, I'll say I'm really glad that I'm again being associated with Z. And as Soni, ma'am, rightly said, that Z really has a bigger vision in life. I think the kind of films that they are acquiring, the kind of you know, the content that's streaming on Z is it's fabulous. And I personally watch most shows on Z because they are really, you know, out of the box. They think beyond, you know, the usual. So I think, first of all, congratulations and thank you very much for having yours truly. It's a very special film for all of us, and all of us know that. When I was, I remember I got a message from Sheila and he was like, will you do the film? And I was like, it was literally like a 10-minute process. It was just 10 minutes. And I think most of my work, that's how I've decided. I've usually always decided it on intuition and instincts. And then Dada sent me the script and I read it. And I was like, this is so beautiful. In today's times when everybody's trying so hard to, you know, churn out content, which is... it's so overwhelming to the brain sometimes, and then it just starts pushing in garbage. So I was just like, in today's times, it's such a declutter from everything. It's about a man and a woman who've never met, and they are having a conversation over letters, and it's the voice. I was like, who writes these things anymore? This is literally out of a fairy tale. Like, it's a book I must have read when I was in school. And, you know, most of us read these kind of stories in school. And nobody makes them, because you don't imagine that you can, you know, make a story like this in today's time. So thank you very much, Dada, for really, you know, writing this, and Sheila for producing content like this. And, you know, they brought in Soni, ma'am, they brought Pankaj Tripathi, there's Mahesh, but why would I say no to a film like this? I was like, when am I ever going to get to share a platform with such amazing actors, such great co-stars? And I had the best time working with Soni, ma'am. And I'm truly very happy today that I found a friend in her. You know, we chat at times, we have conversations beyond films, we have conversations about travel, food. So, you know, I just said yes, because I think the experience of shooting this film was very, very special, yes.
All right. All right. My next question is to the director. So we often only focus on, you know, on the beautiful characters, but it's the director's efforts and inputs, you know, who always portrays the character to appear, look so flawless and so captivating. So I would want to know, what was the ideation behind, you know, starting off the whole content and the format of this very movie that, you know, it's going to be soon launching on C5. How did the inception happen? What struck your mind that you were like, okay, this is it. This is something I have to do. I have to make it happen.
Yeah, so I was looking forward to doing a love story. And in India, you have some specific templates of love stories that is generally seen on screen. So I kind of was looking for something which would excite me and not be a part of that space. And if you see the film, or when you see the film, Mithi Kumar, the character that she plays, if you go by the traditional template, she's like well past her prime, and she should be playing a mother or something in a film. But this woman also has needs, desires, longings, everything. She could be single, she could be living in a house which is 30 kilometers outside of Calcutta, in an old house with a sister not there half the time, but still she has her emotions. So that is also love. And then what she does is, getting into this process and not giving up, this entire idea of hope, you know, which we kind of, these days what I see is, you know, it has to be very instant. So I send someone a text, if that person doesn't reply, it's over, out. But this entire thing of a 10-year journey that she continues, you know, just by writing letters and no replies, you don't even know whether the replies come from him or not, whether that is the same person that she's writing to. So this is something which excited me, you know, the space itself. And of course, the beautiful team that I had. I mean, Sheila is here. I mean, he put the project together. But there's also Nikhil here. There's Milap here. And there's also somebody taking pictures whose beautiful costume that you see in this film, Shilpi. So, Parin, I mean, they're all here. This beautiful team we got together to get this film. And thankfully, now it's on Z5, so more people will see it, because it's one of the most exciting platforms that I can see these days. So, yeah, that's one of the reasons.
All right. Thank you so much. My last question is to you. How has been your experience been working with them? And what is the most, you know, special moment you would want to always cherish and carry forward in the memory lane?
Okay, now see, hum hamesha kehte hai ki aadmi ki tarah har film ki bhi ek kismat hoti hai. So that way, like this film, I met Sanjay for the first time. I guess we met on October 22nd, 2017, and 7 December we started shooting the film. So it happened so quickly. He sent me a 8-pager thing. I read it he has sent me like some 10 days back. I had not read it, but he was checking with me. So I'm embarrassed, okay, I will ask to padhi leta hu. On my way back home, I read it. I liked it very much. I went home, asked my wife to read it. She read it, she said, ye to bahut acha lag raha hai. So I called up Nikhil and Milap, and I told ki, I'm thinking of doing this film. Are you guys in? Unhone next subah bola ki, yes, let's do it. And then that's how it happened. And coming together of Sony Razdan, Ahana Kumra, Mahesh Bhatt sir, I have to tell you, he has been like a, means every film needs a champion, and he's our champion. Matlab mujhe jab bhi zarurat hoti hai, I don't know whether I should say this or not, when I had to show the film to Alia for the first time, I was very scared, kind of, I don't know how I'll handle and all. I told sir, ki, you have to come, no way, I can't handle it alone. He was all the way in Bandra, I said, shuru kara, aadha ghanta pehle main pahunch jaunga. So whenever I needed him, when we are screening the film from Z, sir was always there. So it's like coming together of a lot of good, positive energy. And yeah, so, and I'm thankful so much to Z5, because see, aaj se ek der saal pehle shayad choti film banane ke baad producers, we have to figure out what to do. Ki theatrical mein choti filmon ka koi zyada attraction hota nahi hai. Where do people see such films? So Z5 and platforms like this, the coming of this digital platforms, jo hai, they've given the much needed springboard jo chahiye. Now I'm so happy that this film will be seen by people in 190 countries. Film banate tha, humne socha hi nahi tha. So like, wow. And yes, and I had a fabulous time working with the marketing team of Z5, so full enthusiastic team, and I have to say this, so I really loved working with all of them. Thank you so much.
All right, thank you so much once again for this conversation and being part of it. We are now open for the Q&A to have some questions from the media who has been waiting since a while.
हेलो हेलो हेलो
हाय अरुण
हाय अहाना जी सबसे पहले तो एडवांस में आपको हैप्पी बर्थडे एंड
इट्स टुमारो
टुमारो हाँ एंड सोनी जी एंड अहाना जी सवाल ये है कि जब भी कोई अननोन पर्सन हाँ सोनी मैडम पहले आपसे जानना चाहेंगे जब भी कोई अननोन पर्सन आपसे मिलता है एंड आपको कहता है कि आज आप बहुत अच्छे लग रहे हैं आज आप बहुत ब्यूटीफुल लग रहे हैं आई थिंक आपसे आप अहाना जी आपसे भी बहुत सारे लोगों की ऐसी मुलाकात हुई भी होगी तो क्या फीलिंग होती है एंड ऐसे लोगों को क्या कहना चाहती हैं आप लोग
अच्छा मैं अपनी बात करूंगी पहले हाँ इस उम्र में जब कोई मुझे बोलते हैं कि आप बहुत अच्छी लग रही हैं तो मैं बहुत ग्रेटफुल होती हूँ मैं बोला थैंक यू सो मच यू आर सो काइंड तो ये मेरा So it's always nice for a woman, whatever her age, to be told she's looking good. Whether or not it's true, it doesn't matter. I will suspend my disbelief and I will agree with them. Yeah.
Ahana ji.
मुझे लगता है कि हम लोग gender bias ना हो इसमें तो बहुत अच्छा रहेगा. अगर मैं आपको भी बोलूँ अरुण आप बहुत अच्छे लग रहे हैं. So I think it's एक तारीफ मतलब सबको अच्छा लगता है तारीफ सुनना और झूठी ही सही दो मिनट की सही लेकिन सबको अच्छा लगता है अगर कोई बोले कि यार तूने बहुत अच्छी शर्ट पहनी है या तुम्हारे बाल बड़े अच्छे लग रहे हैं सो आई थिंक सबको तारीफ पसंद है एंड हम थैंक यू बोल के निकल जाते हैं अभी और क्या बोले
हाय गुड आफ्टरनून आर्य मनिया माय क्वेश्चन इज फॉर संजय यू हैव शोन महेश भट्ट क्लिप इन द ट्रेलर एंड द वॉइस ओवर व्हिच हैज बीन प्रोवाइडेड इज एक्चुअली बाय विनय पाठक सो इज देयर अ गिमिक दैट मिस्टर महेश भट्ट इज एक्चुअली प्लेइंग the secret lover or is there somebody else also attached to the entire scene
no actually there is something else which we'll have to wait till the third I mean I don't want to give I mean the reason why we are all here is because we pull it till the third stretch till the third
exactly
so let me do that on behalf of everybody so
okay my second question is the yes. theme which is there is almost quite similar to lunchbox the letter writing thing which is passé out of today's zone so how different is your film because even lunchbox portrayed a similar character where a housewife is doing her normal mundane job and she gets inspired and slightly gets tilted towards a love affair so what are the dramatic changes which one gets to see in your particular
I think there is a big difference between the in the familial space that this character is lives and the character of lunchboxes there is a intrinsic difference in the way they react and also the only thing that is common because it's just a 2-minute trailer The only thing that you might find common at this point of time, just going by the trailer, is the letters, the she writes letters. But intrinsically, I think it's different, and it's been structured differently, the film itself, and also written differently. So there isn't, I don't see that as a major...
Okay. My next question is for the two women in the show, Ahana and Soni ji. Women today, even despite the age they reach in life, always have some desires, always have some hopes of falling in love, but yet they are somehow curbing it. Do you think that trend of the curbing of your actual desires, being a woman or being an Indian woman, has changed over a period of time or is it still the same?
I think the longings of the human heart are timeless. They don't change over time. How you are able to express those longings depends on the kind of society you live in. And so it depends whether you live in a city or in a village or what. But I think what we experience as human beings in terms of the our yearning for somebody to love us or to appreciate us, it doesn't go away. It doesn't go away in my 90-year-old mother. She wants to be valued for who she is. I want to be valued for who I am. You know, I want to be appreciated by my family, if nothing else. So I think this is such a universal emotion. Whether you're 12, whether you're 25, or whether you're 85, it's an emotion that you could feel all your life. So, yeah, that's what I think it really depends on which kind of society you live in. I mean, we have heard of instances, even in our Indian society, of 80-year-olds getting married, or they meet in the old age home. In, you know, things like that. So there are, and of course in the West it happens much more. So I think society is also evolving and changing as the times do change. So people also change. And a lot of baggage has been shared. Today, unfortunately, divorce is much more common. So probably, you know, that's also one of the things you can see. I mean, people don't even want to try in a marriage anymore. The whole point of marriage is that you struggle. Otherwise, you know, what's the point of getting married in the first place? There has to be some kind of a struggle and attaining of something. But nobody wants to do that struggle part. They just want to attain. So nahi hota bhai. So anyway, then they get divorced. So yeah.
I think ma'am has rightly put it. There's a lot of struggle. But yeah, coming to desires, I don't think we should really, you know, try to box India in terms of desires only. I've traveled with a film that spoke about desires, and I traveled to various countries with it, and I was shocked as to how patriarchal societies are across the globe. We are not only dealing with these things in India, everybody is having their struggles across the globe. Every society has women trying to box them in terms of not being able to express their desires. I am extremely thrilled that in India, we are making films about women, older women who are trying to express their desires and wanting to have a desire, because just because you're married and have children and are older, like in your 40s and your 50s, doesn't mean that you don't have any sexual desires left. And you know, it's very nice to show, you know, in Hindi films that we see, at least, you know, that buddha aadmi hai, but they are still romancing 20-year-old some things. But the minute an older actress is paired opposite a younger guy, it becomes like, oh, you know, she's, it becomes like a topic of discussion. So I think at this point of time, I think our filmmakers are being very brave and they're speaking about desires of older women. I really think in popular awards, if the older actresses are now finally being recognized, and it's so lovely to see them getting awards across the table. And it's really, really, like, it goes like, it validates that, you know, tomorrow if I'm 40 and 50 and I still continue to do cinema, I probably will be rewarded for the kind of roles I'm choosing, and not because I'm playing somebody's mother or somebody's aunt or, you know, those things. So, yeah.
Anna. Yeah. Hi. Ma'am ne to apne character ke bare mein bataya, but we want to know your character. Aur dusri baat, you just said, you know, you find a friend in her. So what was the, jo humne chemistry bhi dekhi hai trailer mein, humein dikhai deta hai ki ek badi masti bhara mahol raha hoga. So please talk about that, ki jo ek chemistry hai, what do you want to say about it?
I think we spoke about everything across, you know, except for like work. And that was, I think, the best part about working with Sony ma'am. Actually, you know, hamara jo set ka mahol tha na, bahut chota sa set tha. And I remember when I went the first time to the location, I went with Dada in a train. Hum log ne Howrah se train li, and then we reached the location. And it was amazing. I didn't feel that I came on a set. It didn't feel like a shoot. It never felt overpowering or overwhelming that, arre bapre, yahan lighting ho rahi hai, ye hai. Kuch nahi. Ma'am was sitting in us, we were shooting in what, a 150-year-old house? Like, oh, 350, I got the math wrong. 350 saal purana ghar. It's literally crumbling, falling. But, you know, Kolkata mein ek apna ek sukoon sa hota. I think everything slows down in Kolkata. So I think that's what happened. The minute I entered the room, she met me in such a warm way, it almost felt like I knew her from somewhere, you know, and I'd never met her. So I was like, she was so warm. It was so much love came across. We shared that room together. We would get ready together. We would just do a line run together. We'd sing songs. We'd eat food. And there was one, bagal mein, there was a neighbor who was making food for us and calling us for lunch. Yeah, thanks to me. Because I told them I love Bengali food. And there was so much food. So I think we just, I think that's how we kind of like, you know, there was no, bolte na ki matlab ek, you have to break the ice. I don't think there was any ice. There was too much heat anyways in Kolkata at that time. But I think that was the beauty of just doing this film. Our scenes have come out, I think, beautifully, because there's, I think, an instant chemistry that ma'am and I had. So I'm truly grateful that, you know, I got to work with her. Really, really happy.
Hello, I've come from Calcutta, from Anandalok magazine. My question is to Ahana you, and in this space where we choose our partners swiping left or right, do you see yourself in a space where you have to wait for love to meet the person you are in love with for years? Do you see yourself in that situation?
Why not? I mean, I don't know. I'm not a millennial in my mind. I have never swiped right or left for people. And it's always worked that ways. And I think, you know, it's, आई थिंक समवेयर इट्स अ मिथ सेइंग दैट यू नो अरे हम लोगों को मतलब टिंडर पे मिल जाते हैं दोस्त. मेरी लॉट्स ऑफ फ्रेंड्स, मेरे बहुत सी दोस्त हैं जो अभी लड़के ढूंढ रही हैं बिकॉज दे आर इन माई एज ग्रुप एंड दे आर जस्ट नॉट बीइंग एबल टू फाइंड बॉयज एंड द कॉन्स्टेंट कंप्लेन इसकी लड़के ही नहीं है. सो यू नो दैट्स अ कॉन्स्टेंट कंप्लेन एंड द बॉयज आर हैविंग द सेम कंप्लेन. यार लड़कियाँ आजकल इतनी डिफिकल्ट हो गई हैं, दे हैव देयर डिमांड्स. सो इट्स अ इट्स नॉट ईजी एंड इट्स नॉट ईजी फॉर गर्ल्स और बॉयज. लेट मी पुट इट दैट वे. इवन बॉयज आर स्ट्रगलिंग इक्वली एज मच एज गर्ल्स आर. सो you know, I think if you just wait and have patience, you just find the right person. And as she said, ki, it's not about finding that person, it's about completing the journey together. And marriages are not easy. And you have to work every day of your life. And I see that because everybody around me is married with children. And it's not easy, it's not pleasant. And it's, you know, a lot of struggle every day. So, as we say, like, arre, shaadi nahi chali, divorce kar lete hain, you know, which is becoming such a common phenomena right now. And then you go like, then why did you do so much to get married? You know, people spend, I don't know how much, crores and crores to get married, and then that marriage doesn't last. And then you go like, yaar, maa-baap ke paise kharaab kar diye in logon ne. So it's literally like that. So I don't think it's a, you know, it's a myth trying to find somebody right and left. It's about sustaining a marriage or sustaining a person through your life. And I think everybody out here has far more experience than I am. So I'm sure they have
thank you.
A point of view.
Ahana ma'am, Sony ma'am.
Okay, to this. Sony, would you like to add something to this? Yeah, Lipika here. Hi. Would you like to add
something? What is the question? Sorry.
She was talking about marriage, how difficult it is, and how is the marriage difficult? Yeah, difficult to find boys and girls, and I mean,
well,
whatever.
Exactly.
Was and that the same in your times?
Yes.
Add something more.
It's never been easy to find the right person. So suddenly when two people collide and they think they're right for each other, it's like desperation. Oh my God, don't let this person go. You know, like, I found you. So yeah, I think it is. It's literally like that. And I think it's always been like that. What would I like to say? Yeah, I think about marriage. It is a journey. And but the other thing I would also like to say, and I think we should also recognize this. One of the reasons why there are divorces happening today is not because people are also impatient. It's because women are becoming more empowered, and they're becoming, you know, they have a financial recourse to getting out of the marriage. So I think that is a positive thing. That's not a bad thing. But where I think it's negative is possibly where you're not just willing, because everything is like 18 months and your relationship is over. Either you're married or you're not, the relationship only is over. I don't think that when you come to, you know, to getting into marriage, it is a journey, and it is something that if you go into expecting that it's going to be roses all the way. And they've always told you, I never promised you a rose garden. But you don't really think about what that really means until you get into that situation. And it's only then that you realize that it is an adjustment of status quo constantly. And it is getting to know another person, getting to know boundaries, getting to know who's pushing what buttons, getting to know how you adjust, getting to know how much you will take, how much you respect yourself, how much you, does the other person respect you? So I think it's all about it's a journey of growth and understanding, not only yourself but another person. But that is what's so beautiful about it. So I think I would always recommend it. But you know, who am I to tell people what to do?
All right, ladies and gentlemen, we are going to be taking one last question. Post that, we'll be showcasing some special videos from the movie. So this is the final question.
My question is to all of you. Since Ahana, you've worked in TV, films, and digital space. Sony ma'am, you've worked in all of them as well. So do you think, you know, there are no Fridays in the web space. So do you think if, as an actor, you undertake a project that takes a slight pressure off your back, you know, when you choose a project, there are no Fridays to box you that, you know, there are these numbers that you're designated. There's no ticket counter, basically, running on the digital space.
Well, I do a lot of stage and there's a ticket counter there.
Yeah, but then in the digital space, strictly.
I'm talking, yeah. So the thing is that, see, I haven't done too many films per se that have released. I'm very happy that in today's time and age, I'm really working in a platform and it's giving us the opportunity to be able to, you know, today we as actors are being recognized. And I think that's really lovely. I remember 5 years ago, there's me, Amol, Sumit, all of us sitting in Prithvi Theatre, you know, having chai and like, you know, doing gappabazi, the same thing, you know, going into our respective plays and everything. And, you know, people didn't know us. Although we have been doing so much work, and I'm sure there are lots of artists who've,
you know, dedicated their entire lives because of stage to stage, and nobody knows them because, you know, they're doing the small parts in films. And for them, it doesn't matter whether the film worked or didn't work, because they would still get another small part in another Hindi film. And today's time and age, imagine like a film like Yours Truly, which is a small film, what would be the fate of this film at the box office had it released on a Friday? There would be like people coming trickling in, or they would have not spent so much money on the marketing of the film, because it really isn't, it's not going to break even. Let's like try to understand the math of it. So today, there is a platform that is respecting this, is respecting the artists. There are artists getting jobs today. There's so much employment for content makers. So it's not only because I'm an artist, like I'm an actor. Tomorrow, I'd like to probably produce something. And I still can fearlessly go out there and find a platform and be, you know, on the same page as another platform and be like, hey, I've made this. Do you want to come on board with this? You know, and somebody will produce it and somebody will let the world see it. So I think, you know, now content is king. The writers and directors have to really take center stage. And they are the guys who are like, you know, leading the pack. And we are just following suit. So I think this is a really good time for every content maker. So again, I'm going to say thanks to Zee. I love Zee because I love them as my family, really.
All right, ladies and gentlemen.
Sanjay, so would you like to add to that? Because see, on the web, on the digital space, the content is just basis the merit alone. You know, the people don't really judge who's the star, what is, you know, who's produced it, who's basically directed it. They read the description of it. If they like the trailer, if they like the episodes, they continue with it. Otherwise, it's just a click away from losing your audience. So how do you feel, you know?
I personally think it's much more difficult to make a film for the web or a series for the web, because it just takes 1 second to kind of flip to some other thing. So it's very challenging for everybody involved, especially the writer and the director. And also, I think there could be a tendency of treating this entire OTT like an IPL compared to a test match, which is going to be disastrous. We need to treat it as a test match and give it all the effort and sincere effort that it needs, because it's a very exciting space. I'm thankful to Zee, and you know, because of this, my film is there. But then again, look at the competition that Zee5 has with my film. The other films are a billion films that are there. So I have to be like, you know, everybody in this unit and everybody who's making film, they will actually have to push that much more harder. So I think actually it's a good challenge. If you look at challenges which actually leads you to growing, if you want to grow, I think this is actually a good place to be.
Soni ma'am, hi. Over the years, your work has spoken for you, but in last few days, we saw a different side of you on Twitter, getting into war.